Hello, my talk is on explaining the so-called COCA anomaly of circular traffic queues using PetriNets. The most important contributions are a new connection between high and low level nets and new results of the use of cycloids. More precisely, the sections of this talk are circular traffic queues and the COCA anomaly, the representation of a colored net and its T unfolding, cycloids and the algebra of cycloids. The T unfolding is a cycloid, lengths of processes and coprocesses, and finally, the background of the anomaly and iterations of cycloids. Circular traffic queues are defined by a number of C traffic items called cars, and a number of G co-traffic items called co-cars. Look at a car A0 in front of a co-car U2 like here. They can swap their places, and in the same way A2 here can swap with U0. We present the circular traffic queues also in linear form like this. The size of a system is strongly connected with the length of a recurrent transition sequence, which is a transition sequence reproducing the initial state. In case of 3 cars and 5 co-cars, we obtain a length of 120 transitions. But increasing one of the parameters from 5 to 6, we obtain only 54 transitions. Hence, increasing a parameter can reduce the size of the system. This is what we call the COCA anomaly, as it is not observed when the COCAs are replaced by undistinguishable items like gaps. In an earlier paper, we proved that the formula for the length of a recurrent transition sequence contains the greatest common divisor GCD of G and C, called capital delta, in the denominator. Hence, increasing delta is reducing the size. In a straightforward way, we represent the circular traffic queue by a colored net called n subsum of C and G, like here in the example with 3 cars and 4 co-cars. In order to obtain more information from the graphical representation of the net, a behavior equivalent T-net is constructed. This is done as known from the construction of occurrence nets or net processes. Transition T2 can occur in the colors X equals A2 and Y equals U0. Therefore, we introduce a transition T2 A2 U0. The behavior of T2 is simulated by this transition of the T-net. In the same way, we proceed with T3. And T1. Until the entire T-net N sub T of G and C is constructed. Now the question is asked, how many transitions are generated? Therefore, we look at the sequence of A2 transitions. In the middle of the identifiers, we have A2 everywhere. The indices of the first and the third component are as shown here. They continue like this and are all different until in total we have 28 entries. This value of G times G plus C equals 28 is known from cycloid theory. The entire T-net has 3 times 28 equals 84 transitions and is quite complex in the general case. Fortunately, we could prove that it is isomorphic to a particular type of a cycloid, for which a theoretical basis has been developed. Therefore, for annulus, we use cycloids. Cycloids are generated with respect to the Petri space, which provides an event-oriented coordination system, being infinite in space and time. A finite model is obtained first by defining a section and then by folding and space direction. Next, we do the same in time direction to obtain a finite and cyclic system. The structure is called the fundamental parallelogram of the cycloid. By the identification of all transitions denoted by A in this example, we obtain the circular structure of a cycloid. For instance, we recognize that the path A, B, C, D, A becomes a cycle in the folding. We obtain a known structure, the four seasons net. Generally speaking, cycloids are a subclass of partial cyclic orders. They generalize the well-known token ring structure. They have been used by Petri to find basic Boolean logic gates or to model the Lorentz transformation in relativity theory. Applications are conjectures for virtual token rings in group communications middleware. More formally, transitions of the Petri space are named by their coordinates and give these to their output places. Embedded in the space, this looked like this. Then the squares of the transitions are omitted as well as the circles of the places. In the fundamental parallelogram, we see the vertices O, P, Q, and R. They are defined by parameters alpha and beta equal 2 and 1, as well as gamma and delta. Altogether, we have the cycloid 2, 1, 2, 1. From the definition of the cycloid, we knew that all neighboring parallelograms of the same shape are folded together. This is formally done by a net folding from the Petri space to the cycloid. It has the property to merge equivalent elements. The corresponding equivalence relation is composed by a folding in the direction of the x-axis and the eta-axis. In general, cycloids do not have the property of separated processes. Look at this example 4-3-3-4 starting here. We have only one process instead of three. What we want is a condition on the cycloid to have better disjoint processes of length P equals capital A divided by beta, where A is the total number of transitions. A cycloid with this property is called regular, which holds if and only if beta divides delta. The structure of regular processes generate corresponding coordinates, which are called regular coordinates. They make investigation easier for such cycloids. The graphical representation of a regular cycloid is obtained like this. Here on the same slide, we see a cycloid with standard coordinates as in the Petri space on the left-hand side, and the same cycloid with regular coordinates on the right-hand side. The regular coordinates use pairs consisting of the name of the transition or place and the car in the second component. A first hint to the existence of cycloid algebra was what Petri called the area, which is the number of transitions of a cycloid. Petri did prove the formula alpha times delta plus beta times gamma by geometric deduction. In an earlier paper, we mentioned that it is the determinant of the matrix A. It is a special case of the number of elements of a parallel epiped spanned by two vectors here, alpha minus beta and gamma delta. For tests in equivalence, it is not easy to find the right parameters M and N. The matrix A can be used for a more efficient and algebraic formalism to test equivalence, namely by checking that The application of the inverse of the matrix A to the difference has integer values. A is called the matrix of the cycloid. Its inverse is defined since the determinant of A is greater than zero. We now give another application of cycloid algebra, a procedure to find for an arbitrary point UV like here of the Petri space the unique equivalent point x, y within the fundamental parallelogram. For instance, the regular initial marking is defined like this, and we want to find the equivalent element within the fundamental parallelogram. From the formula to test equivalence, we deduce this vector equation, which defines two lines in red and in blue, meeting at the point C. The idea is now to follow these lines to find the point X. However, we have only two component equations, but four unknown, N, M, X, and Y. The solution is to consider this green line, which is meeting the red line in the point D. Then we compute the solutions lambda and mu. Taking the floor of lambda, we obtain the integer parameter 3, such that from u, adding 3 times the vector minus alpha beta, we come to c. In a similar way, by mu, we come by adding 2 times the vector gamma from the point C to the wanted point X. The result is that X is vector U minus matrix A times vector Mn, where M and N are the floors of the solutions lambda and mu. Let us now describe the isomorphism as presented in the paper. Recall that n sub t is the t unfolding of the colored net for a number of c cars and g co-cars connected by an isomorphism. Now we refer to the proof that n sub t is isomorphic to the cycloid where gamma and delta are c times g divided by delta. As the cycloid is itself a homomorphic image of the Petri space, this is also the case for the colored net. The cycloid of the example looks like this. The definition of the isomorphism map seems to be obvious here, but is not so much here. As seen before, for the T unfolding, the first argument is running through a sequence modulo 7 and general modulo n, while the second argument is running through a sequence modulo 4 and general modulo g. We need a common solution x, which is an instance of the generalized Chinese remainder theorem. A unique solution is given by this formula, where u and v are determined by the so-called Bessus identity. We are using this solution by a function xi 0 of a and b. There is also a closed formula, but for extending the results to more than two streams of cars, the approach using the Chinese remainder theorem will be useful. Xi0 is defined for the process of car 0, while for other cars we have this formula. The isomorphism for transitions is defined like this. The index I for the transition is replaced by the image of G sub G. The index G refers to a car, while the index H refers to a co-car. For this transition of the example, the map becomes this instance. We obtain the transition T8 since the pair 1, 2 maps to 8. To be used in the next section, we now derive the lengths of processes and co-processes. A process is an elementary cycle containing only forward places, modeling the cars. The length is 8 transitions in this example. In the same way, a coprocess is an elementary cycle containing only backward places, modeling the co-cars, with a length of 12 transitions here. We deduce the length of a coprocess by starting from the origin 0, 0 and going in direction of the eta axis until for the first time we meet a point 0 eta equivalent to the origin. For a positive solution eta, we get this computation using cycloid algebra, and for a minimal solution we obtain, which is simplified to p prime equals a divided by the GCD of alpha and gamma. For the example, this is the number of 12 transitions. The result of four processes is obtained in the same way, using the c-axis in place of the eta axis. For the topic, as given in the title of this presentation, we start with a colored net for c equals 3 cars, but g equals 4 gaps, replacing the co-cars. Here, the occurrence of transition T2 is shown. The anomaly is not observable here as well in the behavioral equivalent cycloid 4333. When replacing back the gaps by individual co-cars, the processes have to be enlarged to obtain a recurrent transition sequence. The factor F of this enlargement is called the F factor, which is defined as the smallest positive integer f such that C sub f represents a cycloid where each transition sequence containing all transitions once reproduces the initial state of cars as well of co-cars. How to compute the F factor? Consider a coprocess like here. From cycloid theory, we know that a car A0, for instance, is part of this coprocess after a number of G transitions again and again. Let us call it a G step. Now we ask, how many G steps X are needed to match F times N? Since such a subsequence contains C transitions, the answer is X equals P prime divided by C. With our result for the length P prime equals C times N divided by delta of a coprocess, we obtain X equals N divided by delta and F is G divided by delta. This means that the processes in the original cycloid GCCC has to be repeated F times to show the anomaly. With F equals 4, we obtain the cycloid 4, 3, 12, 12, which is the T-unfolding of the colored nets for C equals 3 cars and G equals 4 co-cars. However, as the GCD of G and C is 1, in this case the anomaly does not occur. Therefore, in the paper, the cycloid for 6 cars and 4 co-cars was presented, where the GCD is 2, as well as the F factor. The cycloid is a twofold iteration of the cycloid 4666. Iterations of cycloids can be defined not only for regular cycloids, but also for unrestricted cycloids. Iterations are defined in the paper using cycloid algebra again. We give an example of its use here. Consider the simple traffic queue with 3 anonymous cars and 4 gaps, which is isomorphic to a simple Petri net and the cycloid 4311. Then the threefold iteration is isomorphic to 4333. If we take 3 copies of 4311, by composition, we obtain the iteration 4333. For an overview, we give the following table, containing circular traffic queues with anonymous cars and gaps, with individual cars and gaps, with individual cars and co-cars, where the anomaly can occur. Then follow the related cycloids with their length of recurrent transition sequence containing delta in the last case. Finally, we have the corresponding iterations. Looking back, we have proved that the colored net which is produced in the anomaly is isomorphic to a particular cycloid. Cycloid algebra has been extended by new results. The Coker anomaly is motivated using the graphical properties of cycloids. The result is embedded in a more general concept of cycloid iteration.